Hi guys, welcome to the Happy Resonance Chemistry. Now we are discussing about some of the problems which is regarding to the spin as well as lap out allowed forbidden transitions, which is nothing but molar absorbance of various transition. Now we looked out at the problem number one, which is given in the December 2012 CSIR exam. The electronic dipole allowed transitions in a D2 configuration. So generally they are giving out D2 configurations. So now we solve the problems in 2 manners. So they are given in the option. That's why we don't need to calculate the D2 terms, D2 ground term as well as first excited term. Okay, they are given in the 4 options. That's why we will choose the 4 options, whether it is allowed transition or forbidden transition. They are given in the 4 transitions. One is 3 of 2, 1D, 3 of 2, 1P, 3 of 2, 3D, 3 of 2, 3P. Okay, so now we are discussing about those transitions generally. So delta S is equal to 0, spin allowed transition. Delta L is equal to plus or minus 1, then it is a lap out allowed transition. Delta J is equal to 0, comma plus or minus 1, that is angular momentum. Delta J is equal to 0, comma plus or minus 1, angular allowed transition, angular momentum allowed transitions. Okay, so this is a lap out allowed, this is a spin allowed transition, allowed transition. So these are the allowed transitions. Otherwise, the remaining all are forbidden transition. So now here the spin multiplicity here 3 to 1. That means delta S is equal to 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. That means it is not equal to the 0 spin forbidden transition. Okay, here it is spin forbidden. Now what about next one here 3 to 1? It is also spin forbidden transition. Now here we have the 2 options. Both are spin allowed. So both are spin allowed. If both are spin allowed, what will happen in case of a Laporte selection rule? Here the third one is F2P. That means L is equal to 3, P is equal to, third one, 3F2, 3D. Okay, L is equal to 3, D is equal to 2. Then delta L is equal to 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So if delta L is equal to plus 1 or minus 1, that is both spin as well as Laporte allowed. Spin as well as Laporte allowed. What will happen in the fourth case? Why it is not? So here F is equal to 3, L value, P is equal to 1. That means 3 minus 1 is equal to 2, which is not equal to the delta L plus 1 or minus 1. So that's why it is a spin forbidden. It is a spin allowed, but a Laporte forbidden transition. It is both spin as well as Laporte allowed selection rule. That's why option number C is our allowed transition. Now we have to look out at the second question, which is very similar question. Both are the similar options, almost all similar options, but they are given in the different manner. Okay, now here they are asking about a certain electronic configuration allowed transition. Now here they are directly asking about a symmetry allowed transition of following complexes. So let us go through the options. 3F1P. Now the next one is 3F1D, 3F3D. Now the third one is 3F1P, fourth one is 3F3P, almost all same options. Okay, now here it is a spin forbidden, here spin allowed, okay, now here spin forbidden, spin allowed, okay, here both having the spin allowed transition, both are spin forbidden, that's why these two are ruled out. Okay, now the elimination method for the solving of questions is better way. Okay, now here these two are eliminated. Now here we have the only two remaining options. Here the second one is L is equal to 3 minus 2, F3D2, that means here one, so here Laporte allowed transition. But in case of a fourth one, L is equal to 3, P is equal to 1, that means 2, Laporte forbidden. So both spin as well as Laporte forbidden is our option. Okay, so now the question option number 2 is correct. Option number 2 is correct. Now we'll go through the third problem. So the third problem, which indicates the lowest energy DD transitions, which is given in the GATE 2018, it's a good question from the GATE. So the lowest energy DD transitions, they are given in the different complexes. So all the complexes which having the same central metal atom. So same central metal atom is there, but they are given in the different ligands. So in case of different ligands, the crystal field splitting gap is more. So here crystal field splitting gap is more and more from increasing the high spin complexes to low spin complexes. High spin complexes to low spin complexes. They are given in the three types of ligand. One is water, second one is ammonia, third one is cyanide. So cyanide is having a large energy when compared to the water is very lower. So ammonia is medium. Ammonia is medium level, which is given in the like our spectrochemical series. Spectrochemical series, ligand field strength. Ligand field strength. Now here the energy levels of water like this, ammonia like this, CN is like this. Okay, if energy level is more, that means they are asking about the lowest energy DD transitions series. Okay, now here, so the lowest energy of DD transition which occurs in case of water, then after the ammonia, then after the cyanide. They are given in the different variations. Cyanide is least, it is wrong. Now here cyanide is least, it is also wrong. Why? Because the cyanide is strong field ligand, that's why it having the more and more energy gap. That means more and more energy gap, that indicates it requires more energy. It requires more energy. So these two are wrong options. Now here ammonia and the cyanide is middle one, it is also wrong option. Now here we'll go through the option number one. Water is a lesser energy, it requires less energy when compared to ammonia. Ammonia is more energy when compared to water, but less energy when compared to cyanide. So cyanide is it requires large energy. That's why option number A is correct. Option number A is correct. Now we'll go through the fourth question, which is given in the GATE 2016. Okay, very wonderful question. In this row of like first row of high spin transition metal complexes, manganese H2O 6 times Cl2, manganese H2O 6 times Cl2, that means here Mn plus 2, Mn plus 2 means D5 configuration with D5 and D7 configuration. So they are given in another configuration which is nothing but D7, so D7 metal ions. In the DD transition, so they are given in the four options. So both are forbidden, both are allowed, both so D5 is allowed, D7 is forbidden, D5 is forbidden, D7 is allowed. They are given the such type of four options. Now let us go through the either allowed or forbidden transitions, allowed or forbidden. So here D5 means, now let us check the first of all spin transition, after that Laporte selection. Now here D5 means T2Z3Eg2. So if electron jump to the higher energy level, that means same spin not allowed according to the Pauli's principle. That's why here spin inversion, electron inversion of spin, that means spin flipping takes place. Flipping, that means here S is equal to 3/2, S is equal to 5/2, then delta S is equal to 5/2 minus 3/2. Now we have discussed earlier delta S is equal to 1 in case of D5. That means here spin forbidden. Delta S is equal to 5 means spin forbidden. Okay, now what about Laporte selection rule? They are asking about both. Okay, they are asking about only spin, that's why we will discuss the only spin. Spin. Okay, so according to the spin selection rule, D5 is spin forbidden. D5 is spin forbidden. Now what about D7 configuration? So here 7 electron, both are high spin means weak field again, 4th, 5th, now here 6th, 7th. Okay, if an electron jump to the higher energy level, now we will get the electronic transition higher energy level like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the 7th one appears over there. Now here the number of unpaired electrons are 3/2. Okay, now here 3/2, here also number of unpaired electrons 1, 2, 3, here 3/2. So now delta S is equal to 3/2 minus 3/2, that means 0. Okay, here D5 is forbidden, D7 is allowed. D5 is forbidden, D7 is allowed. Then now option number C, spin of forbidden for D5, spin allowed from the D7. So option number C is correct. Okay, so option number C is correct. Now we'll go through the final problem. Now we are discussing about problem number 5. So the problem number 5 is, match the complexes given in column 1 with the electronic transitions. The electronic transitions mainly responsible for their color listed in column 2. So they are given in the like complexes and their reason for the color, column 1 and column 2. So which option is a suitable matching for the above column 1 and column 2? Okay, now we'll go through the first one, Fe2 in porphyrin. Okay, so generally porphyrin means it is this type of ring. Okay. Now we did not draw the complete structure of a porphyrin. Okay. Now here, this is the porphyrin type structure. Okay. So this porphyrin trap structures, it having the so many number of pi double bonds. Those pi double bonds can send to the metal atom. So now here we will observe the pi to pi trans, pi star transitions. So in case of iron to porphyrin ring, we will observe iron to porphyrin ring, we will observe the pi to pi star transitions. Okay, it is disclosed in the bioinorganic chemistry. Now here the option number B, that means Mn H2O 6 times, that means Mn plus 2 configuration. Mn plus 2 means D5 configuration. We are already discussed the D5 configuration, that means here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in case of electronic transition, spin flipping takes place. Electron spin flipping takes place. That means here the number of unpaired electrons, spin is 3/2, here spin is 5/2. Delta S is equal to 1. That's why it is Laporte forbidden. Spin forbidden. So the B belongs to spin forbidden. Now the C is cobalt plus 2, that means D7. We are discussed in earlier D7 also. Okay, so D7 is D6 and D7. It is here whenever electronic transition takes place. Same question, but here they are given in the like examples. In previous case, they are given in the only complexes. Okay, now here the seventh electron jumped over there. Now here three unpaired electron, here three unpaired electron. That means 3/2 minus 3/2, delta S is equal to 0. Spin allowed transition. Now according to the their options, here A is equal to pi to pi star, 1 is equal to A. They are given in the 1 is A. Okay, so only B is eliminated. Again, the second one, Mn plus 2. We know that Mn plus 2, that means D5 configuration, both are forbidden. It is spin forbidden as well as Laporte forbidden. So here only they are given in the spin forbidden. B belongs to C. So now the second one, 2 is belongs to the C. Okay, 2 is belongs to the C. So they are represented like here. It is 1, 2, 3. Okay, 2 belongs to C. So here also 2 is so two complex. Two options are there to C. Here A and C. That's why D is eliminated. So D is not 2B. So the final one is 3. 3 is belongs to spin allowed transition. Spin allowed means B. So final one is 3B. That means option number A is correct. Option number C is wrong. Okay, we will go through the, so one is A, pi 2 pi star, Mn plus 2 spin forbidden, 2C. So the third one is the spin allowed DD transitions. Okay, these are the problems which are regarding to the electronic transition, either spin allowed forbidden or Laporte allowed forbidden, or total angular momentum delta J is equal to 0 plus or minus 1, that is means allowed or not equal to the 0 or plus or minus 1, that means forbidden transitions. Okay, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe the channel.